I was born in southeastern Massachusetts, the youngest daughter of Chinese immigrants from Hong Kong. When I was very young, my family owned and operated a Chinese restaurant called China Peony. Restaurant life was tough. My days were filled with seemingly nothing, with no agenda except staying out of the way while both my parents buzzed busily. My father often remained unseen behind a set of swinging double doors that led to the kitchen, which I wasn't allowed in, but I could hear him, or at least what he was doing. Through the muffled sounds of a Chinese kitchen, I connected the constant hisses, sizzles, and clangs with images of my father and the other chefs skillfully frying, chopping, and steaming for hours. The alchemy of sounds and smells, those pungent waves of garlic, ginger, and scallions, seeped through those kitchen doors, filling my nostrils, clinging to my hair, permeating my clothes and penetrating my psyche forever. My mother sat at the restaurant's front counter, clicking away on an old calculator and simultaneously tracking business receipts as well as my behavior. My sister and I naturally found mischief in every corner of that restaurant. There was the time we fastened a bathroom plunger on the ceiling over a table, and it hung there in all its bleak awkwardness, unnoticed, for hours. Another time we coupled a long plank with stacked tables and chairs, constructing a makeshift slide. The contraption exceeded gravity and more. Hairline splinters poked through my plaid spandex like small, ineffective stop sticks, dragged along by the backs of my thighs each time I slid down. I spent much time furiously itching, shifting, and lifting one hip to search out splinters after every prick and poke. Of all the sensations, sights, sounds, and smells of China Peony, something that I remember and have held onto the most is the dust, the perpetual and infinite dust that touched and landed on every surface of that place. Even now, I can see the dust coating the tacky fake fruit placed in the windowsills, as well as on the long strands of beads that curtain the back doorway. That dust, both greasy and dry, clung to my fingertips and chopped my knuckles whenever I touched those things or any other surface. In the long run, the interminable hours and manual labor of running a restaurant didn't produce enough to keep up with my family's growing expenses, so the restaurant closed. I felt immediately sad and nostalgic. China Peony was all I had known, and I had gotten comfortable with its nuances. Although my mother explained the closing of the restaurant as a good thing, I quietly hoped that the change was only temporary.
Thank you.